In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to easily combine stop motion and graphic elements. Hi, my name is Manuel. We'll use post-its as our stop motion elements, prepare them in Photoshop and animate them in After Effects. Lots of reasons to stick around. Let's dive right in. We use a white paper sheet as background. Let's grab some post-its and crumble them up into little paper balls, 5 of each color. Yellow, orange is next, pretty simple. It's so much more fun to create something truly unique instead of just downloading stock pictures. We line them up, make sure it's bright enough, then we simply take a picture from above with our smartphone. Alright, let's open this masterpiece in Photoshop. First, we unlock the layer by clicking on it, OK. Duplicate it and start with the first object. I usually use the magnetic lasso tool. Go around the object. Then invert the selection, Shift Command I, and cut it out, Command X. Once the background is gone, we move the paper ball to the center of the canvas. Or you use the object selection tool, whichever works best. Again, invert the selection, Shift Command I, and cut it out, Command X. Of course, hide the original layer. And repeat that with all the other objects. You should make sure there's some contrast between your background and the actual paper balls. That makes it easier to extract them. In the end, the file should look like that. Each object on a separate layer in the center. Let's decrease the canvas size and save it. Let's create the stop animation. Therefore, we import the PSD file to After Effects. As composition, retain layer sizes, editable layer styles. Here's the comp and all the layers from the PSD file. We create a new comp, Command N, and name it stop. Move it into the comps folder, of course. Then we add a new solid, Command Y, and name it background. Color doesn't matter. We head over to the effects and presets window and add a gradient ramp. We give it a diagonal direction. My color choice is a bright red to purple gradient. And we add lots of ramp scatter to avoid color bending. Next, we grab the title tool and add stop. I use Bio Sans Extra Bold, which is available on Adobe fonts. Size around 400. Color a bright yellow. Then we position it slightly left of the center. Open the position property and add a keyframe at 15 frames. Then we go to the beginning and move the text to the left, out of the screen. We go to 23 frames and move it just a little bit further to the right. The keyframe interpolation is set to auto bezier, so we need to change that to linear. We select all keyframes, go to keyframe interpolation and set it to linear. Okay. Then we open the graph editor. Make sure the snap icon is activated and edit speed graph is selected. We move the left point down and the handle to the right at the same time. Then move the right point down, handle to the left. Awesome. Slow start, hit, and smooth stop. Let's decrease the length of these two handles as far as possible. That's even better. Then we add our paper balls. I use the green ones. Drag the PSD layers into the timeline. Open the scale properties and scale them down. Position them next to the exclamation mark. We need to duplicate some of them to get 9 balls. And rotate them. Then let's give each column a different color for better overview. Green for the left one, orange for the middle one, and pink for the right one. We select all of the PSD layers, open the position and rotation properties, and set keyframes for all layers at 15 frames. That's when the stop text hits. Then we go to 32 frames and move them to the right. Let's actually begin with the right column. We want to avoid linear movements, so we use the handles to adjust the motion path. And we rotate each of the papers in a different direction. Then we select all right keyframes, open the graph editor. Maybe we grab the right position keyframes first and move them down, handles to the left. Then we do the same with all rotation keyframes. Okay, that's annoying. Let's deselect all position properties. That's better. One by one, point to the zero line and handle to the left. Let's check it out. Awesome, getting there. Let's fine-tune the animation though. We move the middle column keyframes one frame to the right, the right column ones two frames. We want the left column to crash into the middle one, then into the right one. Let's make the animation a bit more random by moving some of the right keyframes to the left or right. Alright. One last thing. We need to do some compositing. First, we select all paper layers and pre-compose them. Name the comp pre-paper. Then we head over to the effects and presets window and add posterize time. Set the frame rate to 12 frames. This creates the stop motion effect. Then we add curves. Move the top slightly higher to increase the highlights, the bottom slightly down for more darkness. We added more contrast. Then we add hue saturation to slightly adjust the color. The green is even greener. Next, we add a drop shadow. Distance 5, softness 20. We duplicate it, set the distance to 20 and the softness to 90. Then we add bevel alpha for some light. Change the color into a bright yellow. Almost there. To connect everything even further, let's add a new solid. Color a bright yellow, name it light. We select it, grab the ellipse tool and add a round mask. Like this maybe. Then we open the mask property and set the mask feather to around 400 pixels. Set the opacity of the layer to 25% and the blending mode to add. Finally, we add an adjustment layer. Name it grain. And of course, add grain. We set the viewing mode to final output intensity to 0.5, size 0.5. Awesome. This kind of animation works best when the graphic and stop motion elements interact with each other or complete each other, like in this animation. Try to keep it as simple as possible, as viewers need to understand it in just a few seconds. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and ring the bell to get notified when my next video is coming up. Thanks so much for watching. I really appreciate it. See you in the next video. Bye!